John's Gospel, the fourth Gospel, begins with a prologue or an introduction that gives us some clues about the identity of the child that was born in the town of Bethlehem and was laid in a manger. Verse 1 of John chapter 1 emphasizes the divine origin of Jesus Christ. John says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." If we were to follow the original Greek, the translation of this verse would be the following: what God was, Christ was, or what God is, Christ is, or Christ is in the same class as God. That's the meaning of the Greek word, of the Greek text. So John makes it very clear to us that Jesus pre-existed before his birth of the Virgin Mary. He was with God in the beginning, we're told. We can't imagine a time period when Christ had no existence. He has always existed. And that's why, during an argument with the Pharisees in John chapter 8, verse 58, Jesus told them, "Before Abraham was born, I am." Jesus has always existed. The infant born of the Virgin Mary is, in fact, infinite. And verse 3 of John chapter 1 tells us that Jesus is the creator of this universe. Through him, we're told, all things were made. Christ is the creator of this universe and everything in it, including human beings. He created us. Verse 10 unfolds the tragic truth that the human beings whom Christ created did not recognize him when he came to this world. Look at verse 10. It says, "Although the Word was in the world, yet the world did not recognize him." This is really a great tragedy. Through every Old Testament prophet, God had revealed some aspects of Jesus' life and ministry so that the people would recognize him when he came. Yet the people did not recognize him. Do you know why? Because they blindly followed their religious leaders' interpretation of the scriptures. And those leaders twisted the scriptures to make them fit their own philosophy or their own agenda. Verse 11 is again very, very remorseful. It says he came to his own people, yet his own people rejected him. Now, the interesting thing in the Gospel of John is the title that John has chosen to give to Jesus Christ. John calls Jesus the Word. The Word is the translation of the Greek word logos. And logos is a well-known term in Greek philosophy. wrote their Gospels primarily for the Jews of their day. And that's why they referred to Jesus as the Son of David or the Messiah, the promised Messiah. Those terms would have been meaningless to those who were immersed in Greek philosophy and Greek culture. So John, who wrote the Gospel, his Gospel, while he lived in Ephesus, and the city of Ephesus was a center for Greek learning and Greek culture, he wanted to reach the Greeks, the heathen Greeks of his day, so he chose another title for Jesus. Instead of calling him the Messiah or the Son of David, which were incomprehensible to Greeks, he chose the word Logos, which was well known in Greek philosophy. Now, what does the word Logos mean in Greek philosophy? There was a Greek philosopher who lived in Alexandria, in the city of Alexandria, and he was contemporary of Jesus Christ. He lived during the first century AD. And he has written 40 books about philosophy. And he says, Philo says, the Logos is the bridge between the transcendent God and the material universe. In other words, according to Greek philosophy, the Logos, the word, is the bridge that connects the transcendent God with the material universe. Jesus is the bridge that connects humanity to God. Do you see the rich meaning? The Greeks also perceived the Logos, the word, to be the supreme intelligence that created this universe. So by calling Jesus Logos, the Apostle John emphasizes three facts. One, Jesus is the supreme intelligence that created this universe. Second, Jesus is the bridge that connects humanity to God. And third, the third thing, the Greeks noticed that this universe was dependable. They noticed that there were fixed patterns, like the rising and the setting of the sun, the succession of the four seasons, and the planets had fixed orbits. And they concluded that the Logos was the creative force that stabilizes and sustains the universe. So when we read John 1:1 in English, in the beginning was the word, we don't get all these meanings, which the Greeks who read John 1:1 understood. So for the ancient Greeks, the word Logos has three meanings. The Logos created the universe. The Logos is the bridge that connects man with God, and the Logos is the sustainer of the universe. So all these functions point to a deity. In the beginning was the Word. A word is the audible and visible expression of a thought. If I want to convey my thoughts to you, the only medium I could use are words. I convey my thoughts by using words. And Jesus is called the Word because he is the true expression of the mind of God.